for someone of my height, weight, age, and physical exertion, including an hour or so a day of walking with 40 pounds on my back and another 30 pounds that I'm dragging, somewhere around 2,000 to 2,400 calories per day is what I should be taking to maintain weight and health. I guess it's 40 days plus another 15 days since I've done that. For the first 30 days or so of this hunger strike, I was at zero calories. For the next 10 days, I was at net zero calories, so according to calculations, an hour's worth of backpacking is about 400 calories, and in cheese or peanut butter, I would consume roughly that, so that I was at net zero, but not absolute zero. And since then, thank God, but unexpectedly, I have been in a high growth mode intellectually and spiritually, but it's been driven by readings that I've been doing. The must-read book by Diane Wilson, Diary of an Echo Outlaw. And if pressed, I'd have to say the most important book in existence in this year 2001. Which could be S. Brian Wilson's Blood on the Tracks. Half of People's Voices, compiled by Howard Zinn. All of Deep Green Resistance by Derek Jensen. Half or two-thirds, I think, of Jesus Interrupted. The author's name escapes me, but it's a current acclaimed book, which is what every pastor is taught and never has the balls to pass on from their training as pastors, priests, ministers. So their theology programs, it's the truth about Jesus 101 that has been taught for many, many decades, 101, and none of them has the balls to share with their congregation. Brian's work, Brian Wilson's work as a, I'd have to say he's the most credible human being that I know in this age. He has walked the walk for 40 years, kept his body on the line as a human shield to the world's least of these, particularly the victims of your overprivilege and mine, U.S. Empire. By looking at the other things I know through the clarified lens that his work provides, my life has been turned upside down, upside down, same direction, but oh my goodness, I wasn't seeing the half of the horror. But I understand the disease and the evil, and therefore the outlines of the prescription that much more clearly. It does not give me a different direction. It gives me significantly greater clarity and insight. I suspect that my life's work from now on will much more clearly be around what best encapsulates everything I have learned of importance to date. Afloholism. Curing afloholism. Enabling people to see afloholism. Enabling people to choose thereby whether they want to remain afloholics, whether they want to make their children afloholics, whether they will accept the birth-killing abuse of afloholics, and if not, how best to deal with that choice to stand in the way of the afloholics' unintended but no less deadly destruction of the future of eternity's children. I don't think this will not materially change the direction of my work of the last 12 years, but it will represent a major refinement. I suspect that my notion of the notion of me publishing online and maybe even books as a method and discipline for driving myself to what I just described, the multiple dimensions of what's killing us, afloholism. It's not something I look toward the notion of driving myself with a responsibility toward publishing. With great glee, it's not a personal preference. It wouldn't be high on my list of personal preferences. I haven't been influenced by my personal preferences in many years. What can I do to be the most help right now? And some millions of us, but if only one needs to understand everything there is about this greatest killer, afloholism, which we view as a virtue in the West, as I've viewed as a virtue, as normal most of my adult life, most of my life. I was brought up to view it as virtuous and normal. And we are striving with all our might to get the rest of the world to view it the same. So, one or two of you may have noticed that I've been the number 85, day 85, which includes 35 days of the hunger strike about 2 years ago, 24-hour day occupation of Capitol Hill, to do with Plan B 3.0, ending climate genocide on Capitol Hill, plus the 50-day 60-calorie-a-day hunger strike that I ended in June of this year. That's 85 days, plus 40 for this current hunger strike. 40 has been hovering there for a number of weeks now, and that's because I've been taking between 400 and 1,200 calories a day to maintain my mental acuity during this unexpected but absolutely necessary godsend of intellectual learning activity, recalibrating. There's much Robin Hood work that could actually put me away for much of my life, although what I'm doing, oh my gosh, is so benign, it does nothing to enrich me. If anyone wants to hurt me and put me away, or even by accident comes across it, they can put me away for quite a few lifetimes. What an incredible atrocity and joke that would be relative to the real crimes that are going on, both white collar and otherwise moral. With this awareness that my life's calling now, and this is an awareness of today and yesterday, that my life's calling is likely to be devotion to exploring alcoholism in the ways that I explain may cause me to be less likely to dive the next 10 to 20 pounds down in weight, either at all or as quickly as I anticipated. I just don't know how it's going to work out. My question each moment is, what's the best way for me to serve? Some urgency is taken away from diving the next 10 to 20 pounds with my awareness of alcoholism and how infinitely more, on how much it is our U.S. religion and how infinitely more deadly than I realized it was. Therefore, it would be 100,000 times more of a miracle to wake us up in time to stop global climate change Armageddon.
How are you?
Good, sister, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Fine, thank you. Nice security guard that lets me sit outside here and draw power at some risk to herself. Her boss wouldn't be happy, whoever owns this upscale office building. She and her dad are Ethiopians, and they admire what I do. Saturday and Sunday nights, the cafe that otherwise I can use closes at 5, so this is where I can get 3 or 4 more hours work done after they close while still drawing power. So on the one hand, that much more a miracle is required, meaning that the odds of me making a significant difference are less, but the urgency doesn't change. So my suspicion is that I will continue to drop weight, but more slowly than otherwise. I will continue to spend most clement hours out in front of the White House rather than in a more comfortable cafe where I'm welcome. Another factor, however, is that I may have only 20 days worth of Wi-Fi left and therefore must favor online work, which is best supported in this cafe where I can be over in a corner working and drawing electrons. So there are a number of things balancing. What never is a question is my personal preference. Thank God. Oh my gosh, that's alcoholism. Personal preference is alcoholism. It is. I don't know. I'm not going to moralize and say alcoholism is bad. But I am going to judge that I'm glad I'm not one, and that I feel sorry for my brothers and sisters that are, and given the opportunity, I'd try and give them the opportunity to save themselves. I feel the same way about alcoholism, except alcoholism is always deadly. It takes we, who are supposed to be cells devoted to the well-being of the human body, out of the equation, and it turns us into killer cells. Well intended, just as more deadly than if we could see it, because if we could see it, conscience would come to play and blunt some of our atrocities. Well, there we go, friends.